Yeah, so far we've confiscated more than 20, but at that particular time that we went to court, we had secured 19. So court ordered us to destroy those 19. So today we are destroying the 19, and one cost more than 16,000 Ghana cedis. So we are talking of more than 200,000 Ghana cedis worth of item being destroyed today. Yeah, we've arrested some of them. Some of them have been convicted. But ironically, I see the fine as very low. Looking at the magnitude of their destruction, I was expecting heavy fines. But we are here dealing with a magistrate court, and they also have their limits as to how much they can fine. Our next higher court, which is the circuit court, is about 2.5 hours drive from here. We have some cases there, and it's not easy. If you go to court on Tuesday and you are asked to come on Thursday, I will urge all communities living around the forest reserve to collaborate with us, because the forest belongs to them. We are protecting the forest on behalf of the whole country, and they should lend their support, because most of these activities are being spearheaded by foreigners. I've convicted 4 Guineans and 2 Burkinabes. So you could see that foreigners are taking over our forest reserves. And I'll urge all Ghanaians to be on alert and lend us the support to fight them off.
Finally, what is the level of destruction of the forest? Is it worrying?
Well, I would say that at the moment, the forest is not destroyed. But if we don't put our feet down and it continues like that, in 2 or 3 years' time, it will be very disturbing.